That alter ego was too close to my liking. I don't know what he did to Sebastian, but honestly, I'd rather not even think about it. Welcome to the second chapter of my walkthrough for AKUMU Difficulty. This chapter is called Remnants, and before we move ahead, there's actually a green gel bottle that we can pick up from this toilet right here. Kind of gross, I know, but I guess Sebastian doesn't care and is going to consume it, so good for him, I guess. And now all that we need to do is wait here until our friend, and here she is, comes and opens the door, so we can move on ahead.
Is everyone else all right? The city?
Whatever are you talking about? You are the only soul here, right now.
So now all that we need to do is follow the friendly nurse Tatiana, and the game is going to recommend that you save the game. You don't have to do it though at this point.
I've been hospitalized.
I'm afraid I cannot answer that. Please sign in here. Without signing in, there is no way to ensure your future memories.
We're going to pick up the second collectible in the game, which is behind the chair where you sit down to do your upgrades. So go around the chair and you're going to find the very first map fragment in the game. Here it is. And now all that we need to do is calmly sit on the chair, and another cutscene will play out, so I'm going to let you guys enjoy that.
What the hell?
You mustn't fight it. This is for your own good.
No! Stop!
There now. You see? All better.
Lady, am I going crazy? Huh?
Now what makes you say that? I'll be waiting.
Okay, back in control of Sebastian. In this first segment, we really don't need to worry all that much about enemies. There's two green gel bottles to pick up by the ambulance, so let's collect them. First one is here, and the second one is right here. Make sure you collect this. And there's going to be a third green gel bottle a little bit further on ahead. In this chapter, in total there are 8 collectibles. We already picked up 2, so we have 6 left. And there are also 2 keys. So you don't want to miss those keys because you'll need them, especially in AKUMU difficulty. And now all that we need to do is move forward and pick up the lantern from the floor, and then we'll have moved down and there will be another cutscene. Why would you follow a guy that's got pieces of glass coming out of his skull and arms? That doesn't seem like a very good idea, but then again, maybe Sebastian didn't notice that little detail from the distance. Let's slowly approach him. Okay, there's no point in fighting Connolly here, you'll just waste bullets and time, and you don't want to do that because bullets are precious in this difficulty. So we're just going to dodge him, even though he's a little bit more aggressive than he is in survival and nightmare difficulty. He's not hard to dodge at all, and as soon as you get inside the cave, he'll stop following you. And now let's meet one of the other main characters of the game. There he is.
Hurts! Hurts!
Whoa. Were you warning me about this? You are Leslie, right? I'm a police officer. Maybe I should help you.
Should help you?
Shit. How am I gonna get you to a hospital?
Hospital. 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 Hospital!
What the fuck?
So we need to follow him, but before we do that, disarm this trap. Whenever you disarm traps, you get parts. Most of you already know that, I'm sure. And we're going to need these parts to make bolts for the crossbow a little bit further on. And now we're just going to keep following Leslie. You can pick up a match near this dead body, and there's also some green gel here, so we're going to do that. Afterwards, we're going to pick up the third collectible in the game, the very first journal, which is right through this door. And we will also be prompt to head back towards the safe area, and we actually need to go there because not only do we already have enough green gel to make a few upgrades, but because there are two documents that we can pick up in the safe room. In fact, you need to travel a lot to the safe room because most of the times there's always an article, a newspaper article, and a missing persons poster that you can pick up in the safe rooms in pretty much every chapter.
What the? Back here again? I must be losing it.
Okay, so now we're going to obtain the two collectibles.
I don't know if that was
fourth collectible in the game, a newspaper article, here it is. And now we're going to pick up Leslie's missing person poster. Might not be a bad idea for you to save the game in this section right here. It's a small recommendation that I'm giving you, but things are about to get a lot tougher just after we leave the safe room. So make sure you save your game if, in case you, for some reason, don't manage to follow the plan that I'm going to use. And that way you can always go back to the previous save. Just a suggestion. Upgrade your matches. We're going to be using our matches in the next section. It's the only weapon that I'm going to be using. Well, that and a couple of torches, but those are dropped by the enemies, so it's not a problem that if I use them. And we're going to keep following Leslie. He's going to go through a door, and we're going to have to take down that guy who just got up, the very first. Well, I guess Connolly was a haunted as well, but this is the very first official haunted in my opinion. You can either stab him or actually punch him, let him turn around and just dodge him. He won't follow you to the next area, but I recommend that you finish him off, because who knows, he might drop something. And that's obviously a good thing, even though a lot of the times enemies don't drop anything, which is kind of annoying. Standing right in front of us is the first statue of the game. You use these keys to open lockers in the safe room. Let's pick up the bottle, and we're going to witness another cutscene here.
Hey, are you guys from around here? I don't know where.
Can't go on.
Yep, that's not a good sign, and I still don't quite understand why the light from the lighthouse makes them turn into monsters. I don't think that's ever explained, but oh well. We're going to lure these two enemies right here, make them follow you, As you can see, they move a lot faster in AKUMU difficulty, but burn this stack of hay, and as they approach the stack of hay, they will burn as well. And that's how you knock both of them down without having any problems whatsoever. He dropped a syringe, that's good. I was hoping he would drop a few handgun bullets since I need those a lot more. And syringes are pointless in AKUMU difficulty because, well, if you get hit even just once, you die, so no syringe is going to save your life. Don't forget to pick up these matches, and there's also another syringe here, which we're going to use again. I'm giving myself max health, but like I said, it doesn't really matter. And now let's disarm this trap right here, collect another part, and we're going to move towards the next area. And you'll notice that in AKUMU difficulty there are a ton more enemies in this zone than there are in the survival difficulty and nightmare difficulty. So we're going to hide here. Actually, that dude spotted me, but we're okay because he should only approach the wall and I should still manage to remain in hiding. There we go. So let's just wait for him to turn around. You can also wait for him to go around this area, and then you can catch him from behind as he passes the wall. It's not very hard to do at all. And now we're going to dispose of the second enemy in this area. I'm actually going to let him see me, and I'm going to quickly hit him with the torch. Be careful, because enemies move a lot faster in AKUMU difficulty. As you saw, he was about to strike me with his torch, and if he did, I would have died and I would have to start over. Now let's stab this dude right here, and we're going to move up ahead to collect the second key in this chapter and another collectible, another map fragment. However, be careful, because there's one more haunted than there usually is in survival difficulty here. And look at that, Sebastian's head's on fire. His hair is literally on fire. If I was a haunted and I saw a dude with a burning head approaching me, I'd be scared and I'd be the one running away. But nonetheless, Sebastian isn't affected by the flames, and we're going to kill this guy right here, stab him in the head as well, and we're going to move inside. You might be encouraged to throw a bottle to lure the enemy that just entered the house. Don't do that, because if you do that, it's going to wake up the two bodies that are on the floor in the house, and instead of having to deal with one more haunted, you'll have to deal with two more. Actually, you'll have to deal with three, and you don't want that. So we're going to calmly wait for that haunted right there to turn around. Come on, turn around. Don't move forward a lot, because he will be able to spot you otherwise. And as he opens the door, we're going to slowly approach him and stab him in the head as well. And now we can calmly pick up the map fragment, which would be map fragment number 2, and also destroy all these crates and see if the game is generous enough to give me anything. Not yet. Oh, there's a green gel bottle here, that's good, thank you. Anything else? Please, sir, can I have some more green gel? Nope, I guess I can't. And now we're going to destroy this barricade, but be careful, because as soon as you enter this room, that body is going to get up, and that's why you quickly should use a torch to finish him off. You can try and run away and actually hide underneath the bed in the other room, but you don't need that torch, so might as well use it. Plus, the enemy that we killed outside has a torch as well, so we're going to pick it up and take it with us. Oh, he actually dropped green gel as well, so that's great. And look at that, Sebastian, his body should be burning by now, but I guess he's just immune to fire. Don't forget to enter this little shack right here. A few more matches to pick up, sometimes a few bullets, it really depends. And now we're going to jump towards the other side, and there's at least 5 haunted in this next area, which is a lot, so we're going to use the trap here. pick up the bottle, throw it. All the haunted will come and inspect. The first one will be killed by the detonator that's on the wall. Here he comes. Not very smart. And now we're going to quickly move towards the haystack right here. Place yourself behind it and immediately burn it. If you do this, as the haunted pass, they will burn as well and die automatically. And all of them will burn and you won't have any more problems. If you manage to do this part correctly, then you're pretty much concluded with the chapter. From this point on, it's smooth sailing. But there are a few more haunted to defeat before we can move towards the next area. But again, we need to be... It's not going to be as hard. You might have noticed that I left a bear trap over there. That's my emergency plan. You see, you can actually make haunted get stuck in these bear traps. So if for some reason you lose your torch or the detonator doesn't kill the haunted, you can always make them move towards the bear traps, make them get stuck in the bear traps, and then you can use a match to finish them off. It's a pretty useful method, and that's why I kept that bear trap set still, because I might need to use it to trap the haunted. But if I don't need it, then I'll just go back and collect it so that I can get an extra part. Wait for this haunted to pass towards this room. He peeks through the door, but he moves forward, so don't be scared. And now as he passes, jump to the other side, and we're going to stab him in the head as well. Take him down. He didn't drop anything. These guys aren't generous at all. And there's a bear trap here. Let's disarm it. There we go. Another part. In here. Sometimes I thought there was a bit of a green gel bottle here, but apparently there isn't right now. And there's also a syringe in this back house, but since I already healed myself to maximum capacity and I really don't need syringes, it's pointless to go and pick it up. Make sure you crouch as you approach those two bodies, otherwise they'll get up. And as you notice, there are two more haunted who get up. Usually they wouldn't in the easier difficulty, they wouldn't get up, but on Akumu mode we have to deal with the two of them. So what we're going to do here is lure them towards the trap. One of them at least will explode when the trap detonates and he will die, and then we're going to use the torch to dispose of the second one. If you don't have a torch, then just use one of the bear traps. Lure the haunted towards the bear trap. Make sure he's stuck on it and then just burn him to the ground. Here he comes. Let's use a torch quickly, otherwise he'll hit me and kill me. We don't want that. And we can still collect an extra part here. First, let me get that bear trap that I didn't get to use. And let's disarm this trap right here. Good job. And we're going to move towards the next area, and the chapter is pretty much concluded at this point. However, there's one more collectible to obtain, map fragment number 3, so we're going to do that first, and then all that we need to do is run towards the gate in the next area, and that will conclude this chapter. So as you saw in Akumu difficulty, there are a lot more enemies. The enemies are more aggressive. So you do need to approach the chapter using a different strategy, and that's ultimately why I felt that I needed to do a walkthrough for Akumu difficulty, since the way you approach each chapter is very different than the way that you approach the chapters on the easier difficulty. Now we're just going to move near the lake, and we're actually going to run close to the lake so that we don't attract the attention of all the haunted feasting on the floor. They are eventually going to notice us as we pass here, but at this point the chapter is pretty much concluded, so we're going to witness another cutscene, and after that the chapter is over.
God damn it!
They sure do give up easily, don't they? I mean, they don't even bother to check if Sebastian died or not. But like I said, my friends, this will conclude the second chapter of the game. I hope you found the video useful. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all later for chapter number 3. Take care, my friends.